So this video is solving problems using proportional parts, number one. In order to solve this, we need to set up proportions, and the fact that we have these parallel lines within a triangle tells us we can use proportional parts of a triangle. So 3 and 8 follow the same proportion as x plus 2 does to 12. So let's set up our ratios. So now our job is to cross multiply. 3 times 12 is equal to 8 times the quantity x plus 2. 3 times 12 is 36. And then 8 times the quantity x plus 2, make sure we use the distributive property. And now we'll subtract 96 from both sides of the equation. Wait a minute. 96? That's incorrect. 8 times 2 is 16. So if we subtract 16 from both sides, then we get 8x is equal to 20. Dividing by 8 on both sides gives you that x is equal to 28ths, which both are divisible by 4, and so we get 5 over 2 is our value of x. Let's take a look at another example. So here we have two variables to solve. Let's deal with variable A first. Since A refers to the entire side length of that triangle, we want to figure out the other side length in order to set up our ratios. So 10 came from 6 plus 4. So now we have our ratios. We have 7 and A follow the same ratio as 4 to 10. When you cross multiply, we have 4 times A is equal to 7 times 10. And 7 times 10, of course, is 70. And then we'll divide both sides by 4. And that reduces to the fraction A is 35 halves. So there's A. Now our job is to also find B. So if we think about this figure as two overlapping triangles, this side, the longer side that I actually drew blue, I think color coordination would say it should be red. So 8 corresponds with B in the same way that, let's say, 7 corresponds with 35 over 2. Or maybe an easier one would be 8 divided by B equals 4 divided by 10. So let's set up that ratio. So once again, we have 4 divided by 10 is equal to 8 divided by B. And then we'll cross multiply. We have 4B is equal to 8 times 10, which is 80, and then divide by 4 on both sides. And now we get B is equal to 20.